song written by the sons of Korah. This is why it's pretty important and awesome. The sons of Korah were actually the restored generation of Korah. See, Korah was a man who revolted against Moses when Moses was leading the people of Israel. And there was kind of a curse put on his family because of his disobedience and his rejection of Moses. But there was a remnant of Korah's family who repented and gave their lives back to God. And that they actually became some of the worship leaders in the temple. Well, they started out in the tabernacle that David built, and then the temple that Solomon built that we've been talking about. So Holly's telling me that the sons of Korah were connected to Hannah and Samuel's lineage. So, anyways, I want to read this morning. Because it's such a beautiful expression of our heart to God and the type of prayer, the type of cry out to the Father that we long for. It says, I long to drink of you, O God, drinking deeply from the streams of pleasure flowing from your presence. Where does pleasure flow from? His presence. My longings overwhelm me for more of you. My soul thirsts, it pants, and longs for the living God. That's the song, as the deer pants for water, my soul longs for you. My soul thirsts, it pants, and longs for the living God. I want to come and see the face of God. Day and night, my tears keep falling, and my heart keeps crying for help while my enemies are mocking me over and over, saying, hey, where's this God of yours? And why is he helping you? So I speak over my heartbroken soul. Get that? I speak over my heartbroken soul. Take courage. Remember when you used to be right out front leading the procession of praise, when the great crowd of worshipers gathered to go into the presence of the Lord. You shouted with joy as the sound of passionate celebration filled the air, and the joyous multitude of lovers honored the festival of the Lord. So then, my soul, why would you be depressed? Why would you sink into despair? Just keep hoping and waiting on God, your Savior. For no matter what, I will still sing with praise. For living before his face is my saving grace. Here I am, depressed and downcast. Yet I will still remember you as I ponder the place where your glory streams down from the mighty mountaintops, lofty and majestic, the mountains of your awesome presence. My deep need, here it is, my deep need calls out to the deep kindness of your love. Your waterfall of weeping sent waves of sorrow over my soul, carrying me away, cascading over me like a thundering cataract. Yet all day long, God's promises of love pour over me. Through the night, I sing his songs. For my prayer to God has become my life. I will say to God, you are my mountain of strength. How could you forget me? Why must I suffer this vile oppression of my enemies, these heartless tormentors who are out to kill me? Their wounded words pierce my heart over and over while they say, where is this God of yours? So I say to my soul, do not be discouraged, and do not be disturbed, for I know my God will break through for me. Then I'll have plenty of reason to praise him all over again. Yes, living before his face is my saving grace. This is such a beautiful expression of when we're under attack and when we're feeling the oppression of the enemy, when we're feeling beat down and discouraged, we have to tell our soul how to respond. We have to tell our body how to feel. We have to tell our thoughts what to think. just found out we were pregnant with Hannah, and then here I was just beaten down and broken, and all the expectations that I had put on myself and put on God and put on my circumstances were just lying in a pile on the floor, and I couldn't talk, I couldn't really process anything, I just laid on the couch, and I was in that deep depression, that deep sorrow place, and my mom brought over a stack of scriptures that she thought she was going to use for junior church, or the little Sunday school class that she was teaching, but it was for me, and I did nothing but listen and meditate on the scriptures for all week. I didn't get off the couch. I mean, I was just there. And one of the songs that I sang over and over and over was a song, it was a song written straight out of scripture, and it was out of this passage right here, Psalm 42, and it goes like this. Why so outcast, oh my soul? Put your hope in God. Put your hope in God.
Every change.
maybe if they're a temple thing on or something.
Yeah.
Love you, Jesus.
I'm in the temple this morning.
Yeah.
What's happening?
What?
That's
fun.
Trying to get.
what we can do.
Yes, Lord.
We come into agreement with Him with our words, with our mouth, with our bodies, with our actions. We take the position of praise. We take the position of authority, and we speak the word of the Lord. So we're going to join together to do that for other people right now.
Amen.
There are some fires going on.
Right.
In Hawaii and in Alaska.
Yeah.
And they need rain. They need water. They need these to put out. They're having to evacuate parts of Maui. We have family there that live there. And so there's an out of control fire going on. And so we're going to prophesy together.
Right.
Rain. Supernatural rain. We get to command the weather. So we get to command the weather to come, and we're going to declare, let it rain. And we're going to believe. I want you to imagine a monsoon of rain pouring out over these places, Hawaii and Alaska. The farthest west of the United States that we have. We're going to declare an end to these fires.
Right. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
We thank you that you have already answered.
Yes.
Thank you that before we even speak, you're already working. Before we even ask, you're already producing the answer. So we thank you for your answer.
Thank you.
We thank you, it is done.
Thank you.
May the Lord bless you.